What's up, guys? Daniel Early here, and today I'm going to show you how to edit a perfect portrait using Adobe Lightroom. Let's get started. All right, so what you want to do first is open up your Lightroom catalog. You've already imported all your photos and you got everything here. And the way I like to do it is selecting my photos in full screen by pushing F. And the one I find that I want, I'll push P to flag it. And that'll give it a little flag you can see in the corner. What we're gonna do is create a virtual copy since I've already edited this photo. I'm gonna delete this one. We don't need that. Now that we have the digital copy, we can revert it back to its original state without messing up the original file and edit this photo nice and saucy like. So I like to start with my S curve. You got your highs, your mids, your lows, and I'll add a couple more control points here. I'll bring up my darks, as you can see, kind of affects the really dark shadows. And then maybe another control point, to a little bit more control for the darks and bring just kind of a nice subtle brightness to the photo. Bring the mids up a little bit and the highs up a little bit and just kind of add some brightness to the photo. I'll even drop my ultra highs down, add a little bit of a look. We'll just keep futzing with the S curve a little bit until you get it the way you want it. And you can always change it. Next, we're gonna mess with the exposure, bringing the exposure up a little bit. Then we'll play with the highlights, get the highlights where you want them, get your shadows where you want it. Now you kind of got your base exposure. Next thing you want to work on is clarity. It just adds a little bit more definition. We will go ahead and mess with the vibrancy. I like to add just a little bit of vibrancy because we're going to play with our color and our saturation in just a second when we go down to hues, saturation, and luminance, the HSL. We're going to mess with the hues a little bit just to kind of make everything come alive. We're going to play with our yellows and our greens to kind of get the look that we want. And you can see, you can go kind of crazy with this, get a little creative. I like to keep everything pretty natural looking, but just add a little bit of oomph to, you know, the photo and kind of make everything pop a little bit. Next, we're gonna go to sharpening. And I like to focus on, you know, eyes or whatever the central focus point of a photo is. I also like to, while I'm here, get a little noise reduction. There's my notification to post to Instagram. Just gonna ignore that one. We can adjust the transformation of the photo. It gives you some control afterwards if you maybe were shooting at a weird angle. I kind of like this angle, so I'm not gonna mess with it too much. I always say editing is a constant flow. So you might change something, you might change it back, keep changing it, keep changing back, just kind of keep going, flow with it. So now we're gonna just work on kind of skin. I'm not gonna do too much here, and we're just gonna use the spot removal tool. I like to use healing instead of clone, especially for skin. It kind of just blends the pixels together and makes everything nice and smooth and flawless. Just do a few here, couple fixes of her makeup, and boom. Now we get to my favorite part, which is the eye detail. I actually created a preset brush tool for eyes. So I like to add a little brightness, highlights, and shadows just to kind of make the eyes pop. Definitely some clarity, sharpness, and just a little bit of noise reduction and some saturation so that you can really get those eyes to pop, especially when you're shooting in a shadowy space like this. Zoom out so you don't lose perspective, like, oh shoot, we made them zombie eyes. You know, we're not trying to turn her into a white walker, we're just trying to make those eyes pop a little bit. We're gonna smooth out some of her lines just to make it look all nice and smooth. Taking some of the clarity out of the face just to give it a softer look, but keeping some of that sharpness, and then adding a little noise reduction and just a little brightness. You know, you always want to brighten the face up a little bit. Don't want to make it look dull. So we're just going to add a little soften here, and then a couple final touches on your curves. Make sure everything looks nice and clean and clear the way we want it. And then we will do a final before and after comparison. see if we like it, love it, all right, and we are going to save, export, and call it a day. Thanks for watching. If you guys want to see more videos like this, be sure to leave a comment in the comment section and press subscribe. Push subscribe. And press subscribe.